A few maps in Tower Heroes have mini-bosses. Abandoned Alleyway, Corporate Chaos, Knoddy's Resort, Chaos Kingdom, Rolliday Rumble, Idle Encore, and the recent Cake Factory map all have mini-bosses, and the boss mods that come from them also spawn those mini-bosses. Boss Trio is a mod that spawns all variants of the bosses like... the 4-year-old Slime Invasion Weekly. That spawned all 3 Slime King variants which never returned. But what would happen if you stacked every single mini-boss mod with Boss Trio? I discovered that if you used Boss Trio, it would spawn all the variants of the mini-boss. This is fine for a thing like Rolliday, where Lightshow spawns twice on separate waves. But if you use it with something like Abandoned Alleyway with Gymrat on wave 20, it would spawn him 3 times. However, Knoddy's Resort has the boss on hard mode, so he only spawns once on wave 20, and the normal mode spawned on wave 25. Here's the mod setup. I only added casual bosses and Fox Commander because I liked them as bosses. You can technically push it further because there's more mods that add mini bosses. Bronze Basher, Giant Sandworm, and Crocodile exist, but they're locked behind enemy mods. And there are also spawns on wave 39. Only another boss or two, I guess, added. Demolitionist gets a path because he's a normal boss mod. A while ago, Mafia Boss was behind the Corporate Enemies mod, but they moved it to the boss mod. They didn't start making mini-bosses until very recently, so there wasn't really any consistency for those types of mods yet. We immediately thought of using Gertrude. Our strategy was just sending for a max discount dog, then try to max Gertrudes one by one. For wave 20, we tried to get Dumpster Child to help with Biggie Cheese, but we had a lot of enemy lag and I don't think Dump helped because of that. Halfway, I tried to get Voker, but it was constantly getting stunned by Caroline. When we actually got Vokers and Caroline died, it did alright work of Knoddy. Yeah, remember what I said about boss trio tripling mini-boss spawns? Turns out if you use casual bosses, it randomly spawns the hard variants an additional 2 times for some reason. Probably something to do with not replacing the bosses or something, I have no clue how that happens. After this, then the actual boss wave became filthy rich, and we could actually afford towers for once. Richard was the scariest out of all the bosses because the bombs would just fall out of the map and even Splash would become useless. He could also damage other bosses, which was really funny, and the bridge just caused the bombs to be in one single spot. Richard was only killable because he was at the very edge of Voker's range, and all the bombs just fell to the side, which was pretty lucky. I got pretty scared of Cakesaw, but his rage mode just gets deleted. I thought of using Bomb Float, but we didn't even need it. Wave 30 was pretty much just a break wave. We sold characters because they were lagging the game more than it already is. Seeing 8 furries just start marching and that one electric light show existing was funny until... I was really scared of Manager because he caused us to lose when we did this on Desolate. The fact there's 4 of them, and the map, and all the bosses just being a meat shield, made him able to spawn a ton of baby cakes. Also, he could spawn them at the end of the map if he wanted to. Manager was just a more balanced version of Richard with the summon spam. This is the part where I learned Mafia Boss also spawns on Medium Mode Corporate, which I completely forgot. Junior was the main threat. His defense made him really tanky and let all the bosses get past. The defense made Splash less effective, but we had Lure, so no Splash damage fall off for us. Also, the 3 electric light shows finally showed up. I was worried about Void Reaver being a really annoying fight, but we didn't have the trouble I anticipated, probably because Lure hard carried us. Wave 39 having 3 Mafia bosses was cool. The final wave was mainly hard because it was just 8 bosses at once. One thing that was pretty cool about doing boss rushes is seeing how fast each boss is, and how a few bosses will be close together because they have the same speed. Darkshade and Sylvia got pretty close, Mirai and the Sun only got close because they were being shielded by other bosses. Sylvia got shredded by the Bite and Wafer melee combo. Wafer is OP, guys. Use him always. Maker Cake bosses were the main issue, because they were actually balanced to be actual mini-bosses instead of something that's chucked in some random wave in the 30s. What's funny is that all the beginner maps have mini-bosses, then when you get to the actual hard maps, they just don't have mini-bosses. I'm not saying mini-bosses are the solution to how easy hard maps are, but it's funny to think about sometimes.